Oh my gosh, that is adorable. So much to look at.
Most stuff's a dollar or two.
Okay.
But most stuff's a dollar, but there's a few things that are two, like this big can and the big pot.
All right, thank you.
Yep.
Out of the baseball.
Cute.
First left don't work, use the other left.
Okay, I probably won't.
I hate to see your car get trapped.
I probably won't be long. I know, I was thinking, I was like, man, I don't really know where to park. But. Moaning Myrtle is gonna just like pop out any second. It's kinda neat they have books though, if you're taking a long poop. Alright guys, so I am back from yard sailing. I am going into town in a little bit to get something for lunch, so if I see any yard sales that I didn't get a chance to go to, I might hit up some of those. But I started my day off at a fire hall yard sale around here. It's pretty common for, you know, fire companies to host yard sales. So I went there first, and I wasn't going to because the past couple of years I never really was finding much. But I did go there first, and then I stopped at a community that there just wasn't a lot of yard sales. And then I went to the fill-a-bag rummage sale. So I'm going to show you first what I got at the fire hall yard sale. So basically it's just, you know, you buy a space for some tables and then, you know, you just sell your stuff. So it was tons of people there just, you know, selling their things. So the first thing I got was this bag of goodies, and I paid $2 for the entire bag. So I'm just going to show you what all was inside. The first thing was this Bath & Body Works Oahu Coconut Sunset Body Cream. Oh my gosh, this smells so nice and tropical. Yeah, so I got that to take to work with me just to use on my hands. And then the other stuff, I believe, is all by a company called Yves Rocher, which I have used their stuff before and I really like it. So this one is actually Radiance Shampoo. It just says, I love my planet. And I'm going to take a whiff of it. Oh my gosh, that smells so good. It is so like crisp and clean scented. Oh, I love that. To me, it kind of smells a little bit like, I want to say lemongrass, kind of. It smells really good. And then the other two Yves Rocher products, I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, was this Cream Hydration Long Lasting Hand Cream. And then this is a Foot Repair Balm. So these all look new. So I thought that was a pretty good deal for $2 for that whole bag. Then And there was a lady there selling a bunch of LuLaRoe stuff, and she had a bunch of leggings in my size. I wear the tall and curvy, but I only picked up one pair because I just wasn't, like, super crazy about the prints. But I just got this one that has feathers on it, and it just kind of reminded me of fall. And I like wearing these to bed, just, like, lounging around the house. They're just so comfortable. I never got into the LuLaRoe bandwagon until, you know, after it kind of lost its thing. So these were $3. And then I got two purses. So, are we going to find anything? So the first one I got was this vintage fossil purse. And it's just all leather, kind of like a tan color. It was only 50 cents. Has this little key zipper pull here. And then on the back, it just says fossil embedded here. And then there's a zipper part there. So lots of compartments to go through. Let's see. Nothing in the first one. I think this one's going to be cleaned out, you guys. Oh, that's neat how it, like, kind of zips around the whole way. And this bag's really clean, so I'm not expecting to find anything in here, but there's just so many compartments. And then you have the top compartment here. Oh my gosh, there's even like a little side pocket here. I can barely get my... my finger touched something. I was hoping my... What is that? Look, it's, do they even make this kind of Trident gum anymore? Crystal Frost. Look at it. It's completely flat and nasty. Oh my goodness. So that's probably why that was in there. They probably couldn't fit their fingers in there either. Okay. Well, that was disgusting. So, but 50 cents, that's a really good deal for a fossil bag. And then the other bag, oops, it fell down at my feet. The other bag I got, I paid $1 for, and this is by Stone Mountain. It looks like this. And this is actually my aunt's favorite bag, and I know she's just absolutely going to love this. So I'm really excited to give it to her. Inside is lined like that, and it's just like a really nice leather bag. Again, this is from the same person, so I'm not really expecting to find anything because the bags themselves are in really nice, clean condition. That gum, I think, was just because it was in such a pocket that they probably just couldn't really stick their fingers down in there. But, yeah, that's from my aunt, and she's going to love it because I know my aunt, and I know she's going to love it. Okay, also at that fire company yard sale, my goal for the day was to purchase something I know literally nothing about and just take a chance with it, take a gamble. So I did that today, and this is what I took a chance on. So I haven't looked it up yet, so I don't know if it's worth anything, but it just kind of spoke to me in a way. It's called ElfQuest Book 2. It's got these really cool graphics on. I think it's from 1982, and it's like this entire comic. I thought it was pretty cool, and like I said, I liked the graphics, so that was $1. And then I also bought this one as well. And this one is called the Illustrated, I want to say Roger Zelazny. So this one looked interesting too. So I don't know if these are worth anything or not. But I wanted to try something different, take a chance with something. So that's what I took a chance with. So $1 a piece for those. So we'll see. And then from the same person, and I don't always show the things I pick up for Miss Stone Home. I know I talk about her a lot. I'll link her channel down below. But I'm going to show you some of the things I picked up because they're so stinking cute. I won't go like through everything just so it's a little more of a surprise for her when she gets it. But it was this vintage Valentine's Day card. It says, "Say you'll be mine, dear Valentine." So cute. I don't think there's any other ones in there. That was 50 cents. Then I got this one. This one was a dollar, but I love the fact that it came with its original envelope. Like, that's so cute. It says, "To my sweetheart." So I thought that was really cute. I thought she could use those for a Valentine's Day assemblage box. And then this little packet was 50 cents, and it just has different kind of Valentine-themed pieces in here. And I do see one that says made in Germany right here. So I'm not sure, you know, the year of these or anything like that, but I had to pick them up for her. So I got those. Then I stopped at a random yard sale and I found a Dooney & Burke purse. It's really big, just signature print. Has like feet on the bottom and even came with a matching kind of like makeup coin purse. It's just a nice big satchel. So this was $20, but I thought that was a really good deal, especially, no, well, not only because it's Dooney & Burke, but the fact that it came with a little extra as well kind of sold me. The inside is just slightly dirty, nothing too, you know, crazy, and there's nothing in the bag, so thank God. So yeah, I got that, and I do plan on reselling it. Okay, I had to open up the rest of my windows because it's getting really hot in here. But yeah, so next place I went was the fill-a-bag rummage sale, because I didn't buy anything at the community yard sale that I went to. Like I said, there was barely anybody even having a yard sale. So fill-a-bag, I ended up filling one bag, then I just grabbed a box and started filling the box. So the lady, she just charged me for three bags, which when, because they wanted the box back, so I took two bags, and when I, you know, went out to my car and I filled up the other two bags and so I could take the box in, it ended up being three bags, so that was, you know, accurate. So $9 altogether, because it's $3 for a bag. So I'm just going to go over everything as quickly as possible because I did get a lot of stuff and it's pretty much all to resell. So the first thing I got were these little high-heeled booties. They have just like the studded detailing and a zippered side. And they are by Just Fab and they are a size 6. So I feel like these might be a little slightly too small for me. I'm not sure. So I'll probably sell those. The next pair I got were from Aldo, and these are just funky. They have just this crazy green print all over wedge shoes. And what size are these? These are a 36. I just bopped myself in the head with them. I'm pretty sure that's a size 6, so they were probably donated from the same person. The next pair I got were by Sam Edelman, and they had another pair, but they were like in really bad condition. But these are just little flats. They kind of have like a cutout on the heel. They do need a little bit cleaned up. These are an 8.5. They're called CC flats. But on the bottom, it actually says Samuel Edelman, so I don't know if he has, like, different, or she, I'm not sure, if they have different, what's the word I'm looking for, you know, like, brands kind of thing. So, I got those. I got one purse there, and this was really awesome. Like I said, I didn't go there first, so I'm really surprised this was still there, but I found a vintage Coach purse that looks like this. It still has like the little Coach leather fob there, and it's in really nice condition as well. So we'll take a real quick peek here. See if there is. What is it with gum wrappers? Gum and gum wrappers. There's two of them. There's two. Okay, it does have feet on the bottom. So there is some wear, especially like around like the sides and stuff. But I think with some leather cleaner, still a nice vintage coach bag. So got that. Then I got a lot of clothes to resell. So the first thing I got was this little girl's dress. It's gray and black, striped long sleeves, and it has kind of like an asymmetrical design to it, and it is by Zara Kids, size 13-14. So I threw that in my box. I put this in my box. It's just an Abercrombie and Fitch sweater. It's definitely like sheer. You'd have to wear something underneath of it, but it's not 100% wool, but it definitely has wool in it. It says it's an extra small, but I think it looks kind of oversized. Like, I think I might actually be able to fit it. So, I don't know. I gotta try some stuff on, see if I'm keeping anything. These little shorts. Or no, this isn't shorts. What the hell? This is a skirt. And it just has an elastic band. And it's by, I want to say, what the heck does this say? Lou and Gray by Loft. So I'm guessing that's like a subsidiary of like Ann Taylor. I'm not sure, but I put it in my bag. I just got this bikini bathing suit. The top was adorable. I think this is just by Massimo. But I liked the frilly bandeau top. I got this winter kind of head wrap for your ears to keep your ears and head kind of warm. I love the like rhinestone detailing, and then it has these little buttons here. So I don't know where this is from, if someone made it possibly. I don't know, but it's really nice and feels awesome. So got that. These jeans are by Bullhead. They are just skinny jeans. They have some distressing and everything like that. So I got those to sell. I put these shorts in the bag. They're just by ANA. I might keep these for myself if they fit. They're just like little cutoffs in the back pocket. These are just by Avia. A-V-I-A, they're gray kind of workout shorts, and then they have like a little pink shorts that peek out from underneath. So I got those. I'll probably just use those to like sleep in or something, because I don't really work out. I need to lose weight, but you know how it is. Who wants to do that? I'm sweating enough just sitting in my dang car, so you'd think I'd be losing weight just sitting here sweating. Guess it don't work like that, Michelle. You gotta put in some effort. Next bag. This here, I've never heard of the brand, but it felt like really nice quality. It's just like a long leopard jacket, like kind of like dressy jacket. It's by a company called Chelsea and Theodore. I just thought it was cute and, you know, it felt nice. So we're going to take a chance on it. This black jacket is by White House Black Market. It just kind of has a zip up with ruffle detailing and button. Gosh, sometimes being at the rummage sale though, like really irks my allergies because, you know, some of the clothes have animal hair and stuff like that, and I'm not really allergic to animals, but I guess like all of that, you know, like dandery and stuff like that just flying through the air, it's like, whew. And then this thing here, this is one of those, oh my gosh, what happened to my camera? It's by a company called Earth Rags. It's 50% polyester, 40% acrylic, 10% cotton. It's just got that, oh, I don't know, that feeling. I don't know what these are called. They're just pullover. I want to say they were popular with, like, hippies and stuff like that, but I don't know really, like, the technical term for them. I want to say people called them drug rugs, but that just might be, you know, because of them being associated with hippies wearing them. But it feels brand new. It looks brand new, and I found it just seemed really comfortable. So I don't know if I'm going to keep this or sell it, because I think it would be really nice to have in the fall. So... And then lastly, while I was there, I stopped at their thrift store, and I found this really cute Brooks Brothers tote purse with brown leather trim. It says Brooks Brothers there. There's like a little pocket on the back, and the inside just has this really nice lining, and then there's like leather on the bottom as well. So this was $3, which I thought was a good deal. And then I also picked up this big bag of vintage Avon perfume samples. So that was $1. So I'm curious to go through this and see what all is inside. Like the very first one, there's this Comfort Sense in clean cotton. And I had one of these in, I think it was called like Stonewashed Denim. I had a perfume in that scent and it smelled so nice. So, I don't know if, you know, I'll probably keep some of these just for, like, nostalgia purposes to, like, sniff them if any, like, remind me of, you know, maybe one that I had or, like, my mom had or something like that. And then I'll probably just lot them all up together and maybe put them on eBay or something. But that is everything that I purchased so far today. Like I said, I'm gonna see exactly where we're going for lunch and, you know, see if there's any yard sales close by. Yesterday, I actually, I'll tell you guys about this when I actually do the video haul for it, but yesterday, I went to a yard sale after work, and everything was free. Like, once 2 o'clock hit, everything was free at this yard sale, and I work until 2:30, so, everything was free at the sale, so I can show you guys that. And I actually purchased something from Facebook Marketplace for the first time. Really good deal on some vintage Coach purses. So I will have those two just kind of hauls in another video. So this one's not like 800 hours long. So I hope you guys enjoyed. You have to let me know if you found anything good this week, yard selling or thrift store shopping. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next time.